Hey, hey, everybody. Kevin here with Pursuing Pixels, and welcome back to another edition of Save It for the Cast, and I guess Happy New Year as well. This is our first episode of the new year, and I'm going to keep this intro short and sweet because we've got a whole bunch of stuff to talk about. This is actually a chat that Randall, John, and I had before we recorded the holiday episode, which we just released last week. But yeah, just wanted to say thanks and just kind of a shout out to the everyone who's been listening or watching the stuff on YouTube or participating in the book club and Discord or in the Discord community, wherever you've been tuning into the Pursuing Pixel stuff. We really appreciate all the support we've had over 2021, and we're looking forward to doing some new things and keeping this train rolling in 2022. So I'm going to keep it short and sweet there. Like I said, I'm going to keep be a man of my word for once, and yeah, leave it there, and we'll get into the chit chat and video games talk, and we'll catch you next week otherwise. Finally got some WarioWare playing in the other day. I went over to Tinks, John.
Nice!
He like hit me up, I can't remember when it was. It was maybe like a little before Thanksgiving. Yeah, because we were like, oh, let's, you know, try to sync up after the holidays or whatever. And yeah. So we were, he went over there and he was like, oh, I got Mario Party. And I was like, Mario Party? I was like, does that mean you have a Switch? And I was like, you know what? I'll bring WarioWare over and see what happens.
Yeah.
And we ended up playing that instead. And it's pretty good time. I mean, we just kind of dabbled. We were mostly just catching up and stuff. But
nice.
It was definitely fun finally playing some WarioWare. And more importantly,
there are multiplayer modes aren't in that, aren't there?
There are indeed. Like nice. The actual like campaign itself is like a story mode or like up to two players.
Oh, that's
not four,
awesome.
But nice. You're actually playing cooperatively. It's really cool.
That's sweet.
Yeah. It was a little bit like, again, like we were playing and like we smoked a little bit, and then like
yeah.
Tink was he'd never played a WarioWare game yeah. before, so he was kind of like, what the fuck is going on? So it was kind of kind of perfect. It was just like, oh, let's just go through the story mode. He's like, is this like the whole game? I'm like, yeah, yep, this is the game. I was like, they're micro games yep. for a reason,
oh,
you know.
Yep.
He was like,
the nose.
He's like, that whole game was like 5 seconds. Yep. I was like, yep. I was like, and it's only gonna get faster from there.
Yep.
Oh hell yeah.
It was great. It's a good time. I really like it too. I mean, I'm really looking forward to playing more, but I really dig I'm sure at some point I'll talk about it on the podcast, but like I really dig the character swapping. Like in essentially each like level you play, you pick three characters on like a character select screen,
mm-hmm.
and then it's almost like Marvel versus Capcom style.
Yeah, like a fighting game.
Yeah, and you're like, but it'll just randomly between each mini game, like instead of telling you like the Wii version would like tell you what hand, like what position you have to right. hold the Wii remote in or whatever between each mini game or right before it.
Right.
This just like swaps which character you play as when you go back to like the main, like where it shows your health or how many, you know, lives you have left or whatever. And then it switches your character and then you go back to the next mini game. But so it gives you like a quick second to get the feel of the control.
Yeah.
It's nice. It's done really well.
That's really sweet.
Nice. Yeah. It's good stuff, especially after that getting burned by Mario Golf and being so excited for that. So I was like, okay, I'm excited for WarioWare, and now it actually paid off.
Nice.
It's on my Xmas list. We'll see what happens.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice. I didn't put any games on my Christmas list this year, but I did put those, what is the name of that company that makes those books? Randall, you probably know. Bitmap books, maybe? They do like that unofficial Super Nintendo and NES
or something like that. Yeah.
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 They have like a Super Nintendo one, an NES one.
Oh,
I think
cool.
they just came out with a Master System one.
I thought Nintendo sued them into not being able to do some of that stuff.
I don't know. I'm sure they did, but they're at least still available in one way, shape, or form.
Okay, because like, if we're thinking of the same thing, they had a Kickstarter, and like they had to take it down because Nintendo's team of lawyers attacked them, basically.
I thought it was the Metroid one, like the map for the Metroid one that we were talking about.
Yeah.
Not that one. I think that guy was going to be publishing those through them, I think, if he did. I don't remember.
Okay.
But it like these are just like they're kind of like a compendium sort of thing.
Okay.
Of like, oh, here's like a glossary of like all the. But and then one of them's like a Super Nintendo pixel art book. But maybe it is just as simple as like the right on the thing. It like strictly says like the unofficial Super Nintendo whatever thing. So like maybe it is just as simple as like they just had to put that on it to
I got to
make
find
it legit.
The,
But they look really nice, like the production value of them is really, really rock solid. Like the one, there's one that's like a strictly, that's separate from the compendium. It's just called the Super Nintendo Pixel Book.
Nice.
And it just kind of like focuses more on pixel art in general, like not just kind of going through all the games or most of the games or whatever. But like that one has like, it's again, it's like a super fat, thick coffee table book, but it has like a bunch of those like ribbon bookmarks in it or whatever.
Yeah.
And there's like a bunch of them. It looks like there's almost like a dozen with like different color coded. Like it just looks like a really nice, like put together package.
By genre? Is that what they're categorizing it by?
Those are like, meaning like for yourself to like just use, you know what I mean? Like where you get like a notebook and it has like the little like ribbon to, to put as like a bookmark.
Yes.
More like that. Yeah. I don't, it could like that. They very well could have like a color coding thing, but it looked like it was more just kind of like focusing on like the pixel artistry, you know, not just like, oh, here's the cover of the game and a little blurb about it. It's more like, here's like all these monsters from this game.
Oh, yeah.
Here's all this, whatever. It looked really, nice. Yeah. I'll send the link. I'll drop the links in the Discord later.
I posted in the Discord for the scheduling and such the, Pokemon Trainer Survival Guide that I got back when Red and Blue came out in like the Americas, so like probably 97, 98.
Wow. I love look that at that cover.
Very accurate representations of
Charizard right there.
Charizard, baby. I'm guessing Execute, and who knows what the like thing they're standing behind.
Chazarad, yeah.
Yeah. Like,
that is crazy.
It's wild.
They did a good job with the trainer.
Yeah,
like, it looks like a solid Pokemon trainer.
It does. Yeah,
but
Charizard looking like, I don't even know.
Yeah,
Humpty Dumpty or something
with that fist. Like,
just a meat fist.
God,
that
but
is
like
amazing.
It also had the sprites from Green in it.
Yeah,
so like all those like jacked up, like, because originally the sprites are weird looking. Like, let me find Mew and put that in there.
Red and Green.
But yeah, that was Mew's sprite in Pokemon Green.
Oh god.
Yo, what the hell?
It's like a fetus.
Yep.
Seriously, yeah, that like little
like a sphinx cat, but doing the
space
splits, like just really weird legs on that.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is a weird. That's weird that that's official art. I've actually been thinking about that a lot while I've been playing some of these like Game Boy games, Randall. Like,
yeah.
I actually booted up Wario Land 2 the other day and played. I just booted up 2 and 3 just briefly to just kind of give them a spin.
Yep.
And some of those where I'm just kind of looking at it, I'm like, man, that's like the official design of that character for this game. Like, in some of the, it's very bizarre in some cases.
Very bizarre.
Not that it's even bad, like it's good, but it's just like, man, this is weird.
And like the art style of 2 and 3 is quite a bit different than it is on just regular land.
Yeah, and I don't know if that's just the color being added, but I don't think so.
No.
It's like, Wario's got some different like vibes to his face, and like even just that his shirt is white instead of being yellow just looks weird.
This book's cool. I like that external little cover too. That's nice.
Yeah, they all have like a
cover.
Like cardboard sleeve around them.
Yeah,
it's nice stuff.
Yeah.
I'm excited. I was like, yeah, it's something I would like buy if I had random income, but I don't at the moment. And I was like, my mom keeps pestering me to ask for stuff, so.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to just do the usual, like, let me just add a bunch of games to the list. And I already have a million things I need to play.
I'm serious that I'm probably going to mention it a little bit when we talk about resolutions, but yeah, I'm gonna really try to focus on my backlog this coming year.
Yeah,
like, because there's so much.
Yeah,
like, I do not need to buy another game.
Yep,
unless Metroid Prime 4 comes out
or Breath of the Wild 2.
Prime 4, Breath of the Wild 2, Kirby. Yeah.
God, fuck, I forgot about it. Fuck. Mm-hmm.
There's gonna be a handful.
Yeah. That Kirby game is day one for all of us, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Even if it's the most mediocre, like, I do not care.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, no.
And it might even get...
Yes.
It might even get mediocre reviews, just because I feel like every Kirby game these days does. But
the 3DS
care,
ones
they're
didn't.
They're all pretty fun. Oh, yeah, that's true. Robobot got people went nuts.
Yeah.
Robobot nuts for that one. Unbelievable.
Like, man, I need
such a
I didn't. I still haven't played that one.
Me
I don't
neither.
Even think I have that one.
I own it. It's on my shelf. I haven't popped it in yet.
Like, that's the thing that I love about all modern Kirby games is just they always have, like, puzzles in them that just feel so satisfying, even to, like, not even to, like, actually complete, but, like, I'm so glad that you guys made this puzzle, like, that you thought that this is the steps you needed to complete that. Like, you guys are so good. It's just such a joy in level design.
Fun. Yeah. Low stakes.
Yeah.
Randall, nice. You didn't happen to play NecroCo, did you? Or either of you guys, for that matter.
No.
That like that Game Boy like homebrew game
jam thing I posted, but not yet.
Yeah, I highly recommend it, and it is like very much if a game can. I don't know if they set out to do this, but if a game can be a love letter to the Kirby Game Boy games and Karo Blaster at the same time.
Ooh, baby.
Okay. And I do not say that lightly.
Ooh, baby.
Like, it is very top notch stuff.
That's nice. Must play for me.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's nice and it's short and sweet, but it's got, you know, for a little Game Boy Game Jam game, it took me
That's
like 25, 30 minutes to beat. It
Great.
Was perfect.
Yep. Awesome.
Yeah.
I'm actually going
to
play
it
now.
But like legit replayability, like there's reason to play the levels again.
Nice.
Which is cool.
Yeah.
As I was playing it the whole time, I was like, this is definitely a game that if it comes out in physical form, mm-hmm. I'm definitely going to have to let Randall know and probably mm-hmm. buy one myself.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Although I haven't dipped into that territory yet. The like buying of the homebrew retro games in physical form in their
God.
Retro form.
It's on fire right now. It's crazy right now.
What's that
you
one
can't keep
that,
up.
No.
What's the one handheld that looks like a Game Boy that starts with A?
I thought you were going to say Retrocade, but
are you talking about the Atari Lynx?
No. It's a thing that they're selling now, and I think
I keep seeing people post about it.
Either
Game Boy. Like I'm playing my Pico 8 games on this.
Yeah.
Or,
like you can load ROMs onto it. I know.
Oh.
They were selling it at Target.
Is it just like a Raspberry Pi based thing?
I don't
possibly?
Know. Like,
because I know what you're talking about, or at least I've seen iterations of it. You
I
know?
Think someone in our Discord had it as well, or like they were.
Oh, is it that thing that Arpy had?
Maybe.
Like Arpy has that like really small, like it almost
it looks
like
a Game Boy, a Game Boy Pocket
like a
size.
Mini game. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But it has the four face buttons for like A, X, A, B, U, X, Y.
Nice. And it has like
a
joystick
D-pad
and
a joystick.
D-pad.
Yeah.
Ooh, okay.
It's pretty nice. It's a little small, but I know. And Arpy said like it has Wi-Fi connection.
Okay.
Or connectability. So he's like, you can like load up Pico 8 and like legit do the Splore function and like
beautiful.
Browse for games.
That's
he's like, it's freaking
nice.
Awesome.
That's real nice.
He's like, for that alone, it's worth having.
No, I think. Oh, that reminds me. The Analog Pocket ships this month. Finally.
Oh, that thing is nice looking too.
I'm so
that
excited
is,
about that thing.
I didn't order one because I think I missed the window.
Well,
but
the window
man,
was like literally
slick.
Less than 10 minutes. So
that's true. That's true. But man, that thing is all their stuff looks pretty nice up to this point. But I think just something about putting a screen on something gives it like that slickness that you can't quite have if you're just looking at like a box of a Super Nintendo console, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, that thing looks really nice.
It looks perfect for my needs. And I'm so into like portables now that we've gone down this rabbit hole again. Like, oh
yeah,
it has save states, which none of the other analog consoles do.
Ooh.
So it's like even more that just ease of access. Ugh.
Especially for the handheld games.
Yes.
You know, it's like even if it's just like the game, like every now and then you'll play a game that like doesn't save the high scores or something like that.
Yeah.
It's like just an arcade
game.
It's like, oh, you know what? I'm going to save state my high scores and
absolutely.
Just keep playing off the same file. Like,
yep.
It's awesome.
Yep. Absolutely.
I'm excited. Man, speaking of those Game Boy games too, Randall, I don't know if you've seen them, but I've retweeted a couple of posts that this just random developer is working on some game. It's like, I think it's just called like Clone Boy or something. It's like very Game Boy style, like it just like this blob that you create like clones of your character, and it's like a little puzzle platformer.
Okay, all right.
But they're very much like, they just posted a clip the other day. They're like working on the save or like the menu screen right now, and like had to add a Mario Land Kirby style title screen, and it's literally got like the three tubes, and then you can go down the other tube and like turn into a bomb. And I was like, oh man. I was like, this guy knows what's up with this game. It's looking really good.
Oh, that's sweet. Is he developing it for like actual Game Boy hardware, or is it just
I don't think so. To me, it looks like a little. Well, I don't know. I could see it running on Game Boy, I guess, but he doesn't seem to like be mentioning, like, you know, putting anything about,
which is fine,
retro stuff. It looks really cool.
That's awesome.
I mean, you know, I'm a sucker for a, it's like, you know, single screen puzzle platformer kind of thing. I think it might have a little bit of scrolling, but Donkey Kong style.
Yeah.
But
multiple character thing reminds me of the Misadventures of PB Winterbottom. That was a pretty good little puzzly game.
Throwing back to the early days of the Xbox
360
indie rage.
That's
the
right.
Indie arcade or whatever.
Yep. Yes. Right. Xbox Live Arcade. Yes. Yes.
That was what, and I was it you and I that was talking about that recently, or it might have just been in a Discord somewhere else that it was coming up, but that was kind of the true, like a lot of people are like, oh, Steam saved indie games, but kind of Xbox Live.
Yeah. Oh, Xbox Live for sure.
Second wind more than Steam.
Yes, Xbox for sure. 360 was the home. Like, that was the resurgence of indie.
Yeah.
Well, maybe even this. I don't even know if you could say resurgence, because there wasn't a surgence beforehand, really.
Well, it's a renaissance, but it's what put them on the map and made it like a thing that people actually bought and like talked about. It was like,
yes,
it was like, yo, you can buy a game for $15 and it's as good as Braid. Like,
yeah, and like it's only made what by the
conversations
people.
Were.
Yeah.
Yeah. And like, oh man, those were the glory days. Cause even those, what was it? The Xbox Live Indie, what was like those indie?
Yeah.
They were like even cheaper. Like they were all, every game was like $1.
Oh yeah.
$2.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And they, I forgot what it was like. Cause
some of those games are still in my library actually all the way through the Xbox generations.
Oh, that rules.
Mine are two on my 360, and they would still be on there if I could have recovered my, account on my Xbox.
Yeah.
No dice.
Yeah. Dude, that's my biggest fear.
I guess I can still play them on my 360.
About like Switch 2 or whatever. Because I just don't have the faith that Nintendo's going to let you roll over your library.
Not at all. I have zero faith in that. Yeah, I'm with you.
I'm not looking forward to that at all.
Mm-mm.
I don't know. I didn't even think about that, man.
Look what they did from Wii to Wii U. And then from Wii U to Switch, they're like, fuck you. Start over again. Yeah.
Here's a 30% discount on the virtual console games you bought before.
On your birthday. Oh, you've already bought all these games.
Yeah. Oh god.
Yeah, not gonna be good. Not gonna be good.
It's gonna be bad.
And
yeah, they did. They upcharged you, what was it? Like it was at least $1, maybe $1.50, $2 to get the Wii U version of a game you had already bought on your Wii account that you transferred over.
Yep.
Yeah.
That was a whole thing.
It's like gonna be... what are we paying for? The file storage?
Yeah,
like,
no. You're paying the premium of having a Nintendo system.
Like, yep. Yes.
Like,
yes.
At least that I'll take that over like literally nothing, I guess. You know, just being like start from scratch. But
yeah,
that still is just seems like a
real big fuck you.
Mm-hmm. It seems
for
like,
no reason
to me. Mm-hmm. It seems like they had a meeting and they were like, what is the maximum we could charge?
We can get away
for,
with
like that. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like, how much can we charge where people will be like, I'll just eat it.
Well, this will be a negative news cycle for a month. And then people.
Exactly.
Yeah. It won't kill us, but people will be mad. But they'll also be like, yeah, but I still want to play Mario 3 on my Wii U. So I'll pay $3.
Yep.
You know?
Yep.
And then it's like, buy them again on your 3DS. Buy them again.
That's right.
and then not even really supporting it. And then same thing with the
it's not good. It's not,
well, it's even, not good.
Well, even the online service these days, it's like, especially like they're like subscribe to the new expansion pack. Yeah. And like, yeah, you're offering these new consoles and games now, but like you have no transparency or good track record as of late as far as like putting these out with any consistency. So it's like I could really just be signing up for a thing that's like pretty much been dormant for the last year. You know, they've added what, like 8 games in the last year?
It's been real
12
bad.
Games maybe? Like they've, I feel like there's been like 3 batches.
But I will say I would be ecstatic if they put out some like bullshit garbage N64 games that nobody cares about. I would
hit
lose
me. What
my goddamn.
What's on your
if
mind?
If they put Quest 64 on it,
yeah,
I
should have known.
Fucking lose my mind. Like I
thought you were to go for Wetrix or something.
I will play Aiden's Quest like fun. A million times.
Paper Mario's dropping
mediocre
next month.
Games.
Yeah.
Did they announce Paper Mario?
Yeah. Although people keep saying that the N64 emulator on there is like has lag input, so good luck with that. You know.
Oh yeah.
I could see that. Like I've only tried playing. I mean, I tried playing Star Fox 64, and
I played a bit of that too.
It was a little weird on the Pro controller, so I was like, you know what, I can save this game until I get a wireless N64, because I'm not even touching Ocarina of Time or anything that has like actual C button inputs. Like,
no, God, no. Yeah, you
unless
it feels
unless
good.
C buttons camera
N64 one.
You know, like for Mario 64, I feel like it'd work okay to just like nudge the camera one way or the other, but.
Not for dedicated buttons, though.
But, like, they also, I have the 3D All-Stars, so I do not need, which I think is a superior version of that game.
I
like,
think you're right.
Than whatever version they have. Like, even if it's the same ROM, I'm sure that, like, having it not streaming is just, like, a better version of it. Because,
Yeah, because I've noticed the laggy inputs on the... Like any game that I'm super familiar with that's like baked into my brain, I'm like, I can usually adapt to it. But even like when I play Super Mario World on there, it still just feels like a little I'm not as good as I feel like I normally am when I play that game. I'm like, man, I'm dying. And I'm like, I'm falling in pits. Like that doesn't really happen.
No,
like one after another when I play Mario and like I'm dying on the first level sometimes. It's like, no.
Yeah, that game's in your blood. Like, that's not a good sign.
exactly. But it's like, that's the difference is like, it's just like the smallest where like, if I play something that I've never really played before.
Yeah.
Like, I wonder, like, if you've never played Paper Mario before,
you might be able to
get used to it. Cause it's not, I feel like they don't
it's a new rhythm. It's not.
Yeah.
Like,
and it's not like, like they do the visual cues, but they're not like totally sunk up to where like it's the exact moment you're supposed to push the button kind of thing.
They give you a little bit of leeway. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I wonder.
Yeah.
That'd be interesting. Oh, I also played Yoshi's Story and like those are some weird controls. Like I was just testing out the shoulder buttons and face buttons.
I don't
even
remember what they are. I played the shit out of it. I owned that game back in the day.
I think you used to have to hit Z in order to target, and then you would use the, so like, but you can do that with like X or Y, and it's honestly not bad, but like at the same time, I was like, this is not, I don't remember this. So I don't know.
Just sing me the Apple song.
Yeah.
Call it a day.
Such a cute.
I just
fucking.
It's I feel like cute. All those retro things on Switch should have like controller remapping options because especially with Genesis too, like
they should have remapping options for every game. But
they did have remapping options on the Wii U emulators.
That's right.
They did.
Oh my God,
That's right. That's right.
I love when a company just takes a massive step back for no reason.
They just don't care because we'll keep buying it.
They don't care.
Brand loyalty.
We'll keep buying it.
But it
my loyalty is diminishing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's definitely, I definitely have gotten to the point of, I guess I have bought the last couple. Like I still bought Mario Golf. I bought Metroid Dread.
But they also don't put out a ton. So like.
Yeah. Yeah. And but okay, but old me would have bought Super Mario 3D All-Stars.
Right.
Old me would have bought that, and new me was like, you know what? I'm not supporting this.
Yeah. Literally already so own these like, games.
Yeah, or like Pikmin 3 Deluxe. Like I was kind of like, hey, I feel like the superior way to play is with the two screens on the Wii U.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I'm just, God, I don't need to have this.
Yeah. Man, is 2022 the year of the Wii U where I just like oh. boot back Xenoblade Chronicles Dude. X back up?
Let me know if you do that.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you do it. Because one of the things that I've been wanting to do, potentially for a stream, but just in general, but I've been wanting to play the Metroid Prime trilogy on Wii, in which on my Wii U is how I would play it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It'd be interesting. Yeah, I don't know. That could be fun. Mm-hmm. I personally like the Wii controls. Like with the pointing and aiming as opposed to the
I didn't dislike it
stick controls,
but like I've played one and two
yeah
so many times that like I feel like it would just I don't think I could stomach it.
It doesn't feel I know what you mean, like this feels wrong.
You have synergy with that game, those games.
And I've only played through Metroid Prime 3 twice, so I don't have that baked in.
Yeah. Only played it twice.
I've never beaten two.
It up. Wait, which really? Is,
I've played two to like 99% completion and never beaten the final boss because it's too fucking hard.
Oh my God.
Okay.
And I'm like, it's one of my favorite games, but I've never beaten it.
Jeez.
Yeah, I was going to say, I know people seem to love that one the most out of the trilogy, at least from what I recall.
Man, eh. I'd say the sentiment is more around the first one from what I've gathered.
I'm
maybe that was back in the day when I was collecting, but I sort of remember maybe I just thought the cover was cool.
Oh, the cover's amazing.
Olive oil?
The cover's unreal. Yeah.
Such a good one.
That might be literally all I'm thinking of. Like,
it's
I
sweet.
Remember that one being better. But yeah, I did like quite a bit. And like, I probably got 5 hours into the first one whenever I played it, and I was quite enjoying it. I just didn't have, you know how I am.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Never finish anything, but.
I mean, yeah, how many of my games have I ever finished? How many games have I put in 100 hours and never finished?
Like, I would be curious to know how many games you've put in 100 hours on, just in general.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
I would, too.
You have a decent list, I think.
I can definitely name five right off the bat.
Breath of the Wild, Genshin Impact.
Fuck,
I hadn't even thought of those.
Xenoblade Chronicles. What else?
Tony Hawk.
Tony Hawk.
Like 85 last time.
Final Fantasy Tactics Advance.
Sure.
Like easily, like even though it's only like
Animal Crossing.
Animal Crossing.
Every iteation of it, probably.
Yeah. Well, I've only played New Leaf and New Horizons.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
But yeah, I've definitely put in over 100 hours on that.
Yeah, that's easy.
Advance Wars of some kind.
Oh, God, yeah. Advance Wars. I put it in every iteration of that. Fire Emblem.
Castlevania's of some kind.
To too.
Castlevania. Good Lord, dude. Like, I just don't play a ton. I play the same, like, 24 games. And I just play them over and over again.
You know what you like.
I do know what I like. It's very specific because it's only those games.
There's something to be said about that, though.
Totally.
Like, a game that doesn't lose its luster over multiple playthroughs is, like, that's magic, man.
It is magic. Oh, man. Especially if it has the depth to support that. Like, that's awesome. Yeah.
I don't know if most of those games actually have the depth or if I'm just a weird guy.
Checking all the boxes.
That's also, right.
I think these overalls are very clicky, so I'm going to remove that.
I love that clip you posted of like trying to get the whole map on Metroid, John, where you're like jumping, doing that spin jump all over the place.
My brain is so broken. Like, it's a great feature in the game because are times when you are stuck and then you can look at the map and be like, I've never even gone to that corner.
Absolutely.
And so then you go there and you're like, oh, look, there's a little path that I never noticed before. But it is why couldn't they have made it like a block? Like, why did it have to be pixels on the map? Like, couldn't they just do it like here? Oh, yeah, this is broken into six segments.
Into a grid of some kind. Yeah.
Just that map is not my favorite part of that. But it's a good
Yeah.
I'm excited to play more of that game. I haven't played since we talked about it last, but I keep, it's sitting right at, it's still in the system, but it's sitting right at like kind of out where it's like calling my name, and I keep meaning to play more, but just haven't yet.
Mm-hmm.
Have you played any more since we chatted about it, Randall?
I have.
Ooh. Interesting. Nice.
Should we get started soon?
I'm proposing that if we're going to do the same method we did last time, that John goes before me also, all because right. John, all of John's games last time were talked about before John had an opportunity.
That's a good point. That is a very good point.
Do you think we're going to have 100% overlap this year?
No.
No, not
100%.
So. Yeah.
I would wager that all mine will be unique, I think.
I also think that's probably...
Yeah,
accurate. I think you will have zero overlap.
Probably. Yeah, definitely. But I think I very easily could. Like, I had a lot of potential, a lot of close calls.
There's a ton of honorable mentions for me.
Me too. I'm going to say mine. I'm sorry. I have like three. I'm sorry. I'm not going to spend a shit ton of time on them, but I'm going to mention them.
Yeah, absolutely. For sure.
I'm going to, mention, because.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mention it was that Genshin. Hard.
Mention the Genshin. Yeah. God damn it. Oh, boy. Ugh. I have not spent any more money on that game, but like.
Nice.
Ugh, God damn. Well, but it's also because I'm at the point where like there's like a cliff or like a wall that people reach where like they've done all the content and it's like they're just caught up and like doing the game as it comes and like. People like will talk like it's a very systematic and methodical thing where they'll log in, do the daily like quests and log out. And I'm like, that sucks. Like, I don't like that.
That's but like my NBA experience pretty much. Yeah.
And like I'm kind of there, but I'm still like fucking around and doing stuff that isn't like. I don't know, just hanging out and grinding and doing stuff, but like there's nothing to do in it, which does kind of suck, but at the same time I'm like, still having fun. Like
maintenance still, mode.
Like, yeah.
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 Still works.
You can't like grind a little or anything.
Oh buddy. It's so exponential. No, like I'm trying to like do the mental math in my head. There are three items that give you experience that level up your character. And one of them gives you the lowest tier gives you 1,000 experience. The next one I think gives you 4,000. So then the next one has to give you 10,000. Beating a single enemy at the highest world level gives you 20 experience.
Oh no.
And you need to like, if it's 10,000, that can't be right, though. That can't be. I don't know.
It might be.
It might be, because once you get to the higher levels, it takes about 100,000 experience to upgrade to the next level. Mm-hmm. So you cannot, like, you can level up for the first 20 levels.
I can tell you how you can level up, John. Yeah, easily.
What? Just for the low, low price of $4 a month. I log in every day, get those Primo gems. You can spend those and
for only 4 monthly payments of $19.99.
Easy payments.
Yeah, but like, there's also like, I am so averse to gambling in like any.
Yeah.
Like format that like I just like start it and I'm like, no. I like there's no like it has zero appeal to me. Whereas like people will log in and like pay to get their like wishes that they can use to roll. And I'm like, no, I in the past three that I've done, which has been over like a month, like I've gotten no characters and I'm like, man, all right. Yeah. M's the breaks. That's just what I'm like. So when you get a duplicate of a character, instead of getting
that character or nothing, they give you something that upgrades a second skill tree for them. And there are six constellation stars that, like, you level up. So if you get duplicates of a character six times, that's when they're maxed out in their constellation.
Okay.
And, like, so think about how it took me a month of just playing the game normally, not, like, putting any money into it, basically, of getting zero characters. Imagine what the roll is, or the, like, gamble that you're doing to get six of these same characters.
The duplicate.
Like,
yeah.
The amount of money people is spending on this game is unfathomable to me.
Yeah.
And, like, it's just, it topples over. Once you start, I know from experience, like, if you throw money at the thing too much, it topples it over, and then it's not fun because the curve is gone.
Right.
Yeah. And it's like, there's no way to balance the game when you have those elements in play.
Yep. Spending money once was enough to me, like, that didn't satisfy that itch at all. Like,
right. But you had to try. Like, I get that too. Yeah.
Yeah. And again, like, you got to support, not GATA, but, you know, because they are a huge corporation sort of at this point, but still it's like, you know, you are like, hey, I've spent a ton of time playing this and it is fun.
Yes.
People work on it and, you know, I can kind of support that, or I can get behind that.
Yep. And the soundtrack is unbelievable.
Like, that's so wild.
It is such a good soundtrack, dude.
I really need to just boot it up. I kind of want to just see it in action. Like, because I really like whenever we talk about it on the podcast and then I go look for, like, a GIF to post or something, I'm always
it looks sick as shit.
Yeah, I'm always and I'm always a little surprised. Like, I'm always like, this is a little different. Like, every time I'm like, this style is a little different than I remember. Like, for some, it's got a little more cell shading than I realize it has. Like, it kind of reminds me of Okami almost a little bit. Like, some of the grass or bushes in the background that'll be just swaying in the wind. I'm like, that's got an Okami vibe going on there.
It's stylized enough that it doesn't need to be super defined.
Right. Yeah.
It is super simple. Like the trees have only one dimension on the leaves or whatever, but it doesn't need to be. Like, it looks good.
But so does Mario Golf, and it looks like shit. It can be done in a way where, if you're not trying to make it look real, it can look awesome.
That's honestly a genius business strategy for them with Genshin to do it that way, because it's a PC game. Yeah. Everyone's got different specs. People with very low-end machines can have a great experience with the stylized graphics.
Maybe I have.
Well, even your computer's how old, John?
Oh, yeah, I have no idea. This is a used computer from a friend, that he had when we lived together. Oh, God, how many years ago was that? Ooh, 2013?
At least 5,
2014? Before, before Trump got elected. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. But, yeah, also playing it on mobile. Like, it looks incredible on mobile.
That's wild.
Which is unbelievable.
Yeah. That's wild.
Yeah, boot it up on your iPhone. Like, if it handles weird. Like, if you're used to, I play it on a controller. I don't even play mouse and keyboard, which, like, people, apparently that's the preferred way to do it, but I like playing on a controller.
Totally.
I can't play mouse and keyboard, man.
It's too,
I just can't.
Yeah. I can do it for some game. I can do it for an FPS.
Yeah, same. FPS or strategy. Yeah. Give me, I can do mouse and keyboard.
Oh, if it's if it's just top down clicking and that kind of thing. Yeah.
I can't imagine playing an RTS without.
There's a few
StarCraft 64, baby.
there's a few games that I feel.
What if that's on the Nintendo Online?
Oh, that would be amazing.
With
I would
a partnership
love to
with
just
Blizzard.
Try that out again.
Oh, when they have Overwatch 2 come out and they release StarCraft 64.
Oh my God. But they totally could, as far as affording to do it.
That's fine, because then I wouldn't have to give Blizzard any more money directly. They would just put it on that service.
They wouldn't let. Yeah, no. They're so Blizzard's so weird about what versions of their game, because you can't play Warcraft 3 anymore, right? You can only play
the old version. I doubt it. Yeah.
I think they removed it from Battle.net.
Probably.
Which is wild.